Look up. And down.
Everything seems okay there. Do you have any headaches?
No.
Have any worries?
What do you mean, worries?
Well, how do you get on with your family?
Okay.
How about school?
Good.
What about nightmares?
So that's it. I thought this was just a checkup.
This is just a checkup, and you're a very healthy young fella. But your father's worried about those nightmares.
He's only worried because I yell a bit in my sleep and wake him up. Well, anyway, they're just dreams. Everyone dreams, don't they?
Yes. Do you remember what they're about?
No. Sorry.
Any other problems?
Yeah. Well, my father doesn't understand me. Can I go now?
I guess so.
Careful not to crush this. You might have to run an iron over it in the morning.
All right, then. Okay, thank you. And I'll see you after the wedding.
Right. Have a good time.
Yes.
And tell Lorraine I'm sure she'll be a beautiful bride.
Yes, yeah, she will, won't she? This is a lucky man. See you later.
Bye.
Anyway, I don't know why she's going on about it. There's not going to be any mess, eh?
Yeah, better give her a ring. Probably won't get much of a chance once the guys turn up.
Okay.
Church.
Yeah.
Any last minute message for Lorraine?
No, I'm just about to ring her.
Oh, good idea. Listen, don't drink too much tonight.
Don't worry.
Good. Good-o. Scott, hold that, will you?
Hey, Danny, tell Shane to get a move on, will you?
Oh, yeah, okay.
Hello?
Is that Daphne? Hi, my name's Ramsey, Shane Ramsey.
Yes, Mr. Ramsey?
We're having a bucks party for a mate tonight. I was wondering if you'd be available.
What do you want done?
Oh, just a bit of dancing, you know.
Well,
make sure you eat it.
Notice. I've got another booking just before midnight.
Oh, that's fine. Any time after midnight's okay.
Who's calling for you, Shane?
I'll give you the address.
Did you see a doctor?
24
Ramsey
Street. Uh-huh. Great. Great. Bye.
What did he say? He said I'm having nightmares. Dad didn't have to go telling him that.
Come on, Danny. You won't tell us what's wrong with you. Look, what else can we do?
Mum, I keep telling you, there's nothing wrong with me.
Danny, please.
Well, I'm off then. See you tomorrow.
I still think you should find time to have a decent meal.
You just don't understand, do you? A bucks party takes a lot of organisation. It's got to be something old Desi will remember for the rest of his married life.
Oh, yes, but why in this street? You know what your father's like about noise?
We'll be so quiet, Mum. He won't even know we're in there. I promise.
I want you both to drink this and get straight into bed.
No chatting on till midnight.
Don't worry, Mrs. Kingham. I'll make sure she gets to bed.
How's Daddy?
Still sulking. Oh, well, you know, Lorraine is his only daughter.
Yes. Never mind. He'll get used to her being married. Good night, Julie.
Good night, Mrs. Kingham.
Sleep well, darling.
Good night, Mum.
Tomorrow is meant to be the happiest day of your life, remember?
I just wish Daddy liked him, that's all.
But the thing is that you love him. That's all that matters. You know, Lorraine, I really admire you. Nothing your father can say is going to change your mind. You love Des. And look, so many girls get married. You know, and they're not really sure. But then look at us. When I was going out with Des, you know, I just knew. I just knew he was not right for me. And then you started the bank and you just knew.
Why wasn't he right for you?
Oh, I don't know. I don't know. Well, he isn't really a spunk, is he? I mean, you know, he's nice. He's ordinary. He'll make a great father, for sure. He's a little bit set in his ways, and I suppose that's a good thing. Although
what?
Lorraine, look what we're both doing. We're picking on poor old Des to pieces the night before the wedding. No. You love him. I mean, he's one of my best friends. You're going to be our neighbours and we're going to live happily ever after.
Yeah. Daddy hates him, you know.
I know. Oh, well, but you know, he isn't the one that has to love, honour and obey him, is he? You know, Lorraine, I just hope that when I get married, that I love my guy as much as you must love Des.
Sleep, will you? And shut up, for Pete's sake. It's two in the flaming morning.
Shh. It's all right, Debbie. It's fine. It's all right.
What's all that music?
That Bucks party.
A terrible dream.
You sure did. Your father was just about to break up that party, and you started to yell again.
And he leaves them alone. It's their party.
Yes, but they could have turned it down after midnight. She's getting worse. Remember what you were dreaming about?
No. No, I can't.
Flaming Bucks parties. It's Max. Now listen, what are you going to do about them bloody neighbours of yours?
Oh, come on, mate. It's the poor guy's last night of freedom. I'll pack it in soon.
Oh, they'll pack it in all right. If you don't tell them to belt up, I'll be in there myself.
Leave it to me, mate.
What's a girl doing in there?
Probably a stripper. They usually have strippers at dudes like that.
That sounds like your son again. I hope he doesn't remember that tomorrow. Does the stripper really leap out of the cake?
Only in Hollywood.
How was Max?
Oh, he's fine. I told him I'd take care of it. But if they don't stop soon, he'll be over there like a wild bull.
I can't sleep.
Oh. I know, darling. Come on. It'll be over soon.
I hope Paul telling those dirty jokes again, Grandma.
Oh, they're really not dirty, just silly.
Grandma, what are you doing here?
More to the point, what are you?
Dad, Lucy.
You haven't been next door, have you?
No, I haven't.
I thought you were in bed. Where have you been?
Just out. You're not up because of me, are you?
No, no one can sleep because of all that racket.
The Ramsey's lights are on as well.
Yeah, we know.
Yeah, well, good night.
Hold it. You were supposed to be in by midnight. Where have you been?
I'll get it. Hello?
Who's that?
It's Scott.
Put your old man on.
Talk to you in the morning. Here's Max.
What happened?
Give him another 15 minutes, mate.
Like hell I will. Some of us have got to work in the morning, remember?
Tomorrow's Saturday, Max.
Cripes! Even the flaming dogs are at it now. Okay, okay. I'll stop it myself.
Max, sometimes I'm very grateful to Max Ramsey and that temper of his.
Sorry for young Des. He did ask us if we'd mind him having a party.
Yes, but he did say that it'd be over by 1 o'clock. And from the sound of it, they could still be there when it comes time to go to the church.
Right.
Good night, my dear.
Good night. Oh, no.
I believe the best man lives here.
Hi, Dad. Great party.
Morning, Mr. Ramsey.
Oh, g'day, Scott. Hey, what are you still doing here?
Going for a swim. Where's Shane?
He's getting changed. Like an old woman this morning. Blaming parties, going to all hours. Won't do his training much good, you know.
Danny, Scott.
Oh, here you are at last.
Where's the girls?
What girls?
They've both come here to chat up a couple of girls from school. Don't think they'd just come to watch me train, do you?
Oh, you're going
to
train, are you?
Sorry.
Try and get that pike fixed first, OK?
What's the matter with you anyway?
What do you mean?
Are you sick or something?
No.
Look, he's ready.
Take your time now.
Shane!
Yeah?
Be careful, okay?
Look, what are you?
Sorry. Sorry.
Better,
eh? I'm going home.
Paul, it's 8 o'clock.
Yeah, thanks, Dad. I'm up.
Bit he's suffering.
What about Des? Best in the son of life next door.
Thanks, I will. Paul's the best man. The groom's his responsibility. I can just see the two of them holding each other up at the wedding, can't you? Speak of the devil.
Morning. Morning, Grandma.
Morning, dear. Eggs and bacon?
Oh, no, thanks.
Tea? Coffee?
Yeah, coffee, thanks, Grandma.
Oh, no, I'll get it. Al, you've got a big day ahead of you, haven't you?
Yeah.
Being best man at a wedding's big responsibility. Now, where is that coffee?
Leave it, Jim. I'll do it.
Oh, thanks, Mum. Oh, that'll be the phone. No, don't worry, I'll go.
He's really enjoying himself, isn't he?
He certainly is.
Hello, Jim Robinson.
Hi, Mr. Robinson. It's Des.
Des! How are you, my dear old chap, on this bright and very auspicious morning?
Is Paul up yet?
Is he up? He's having breakfast. Why don't you leap the fence and join us? We're having tripe and onions.
No, thanks.
Well, you've got to eat, you know. Man's got to eat before he gets married. You want to talk to Paul?
Yeah.
All right, sure. Paul!
It's for you.
Thanks. Hi. Is your old man always that bright?
He's got a bit of a sadistic streak.
Hell yeah. Don't ask. Hey, listen, something's wrong.
What do you mean?
Lorraine just phoned up and she's coming over with her parents. They all want to talk to me.
What about?
Don't know. Is Julie said anything?
No, Julie stayed at Lorraine's, the bridesmaid thing, remember?
Oh, yeah. It's a bit strange, though. Lorraine coming over here.
Yeah, bad luck as well. Hang on a second, Des. Julie's just walked in the door now. Listen, it's Des. He said Lorraine and her parents are coming over to talk.
Hey, Paul. A car's just pulled up. It could be then. I'll just check. I'll call you back. See you, mate.
Julie?
What's going on?
Oh, look, I don't want to talk about it.
What do you mean you don't want to talk about it? Des said Lorraine and her parents are coming over now.
They are. I came on ahead. Hi.
Yeah?
You don't remember me. I'm Daphne.
Daphne?
The stripper from last night.
Oh, yeah. I didn't recognise you.
With clothes on. Yeah, I know. Do you mind if I come in? I know exactly where it is. Right under here. If I hadn't left in such a hurry last night. Oh, that's funny. It's not there.
Why don't you just take the whole thing off?
It's got to be there. That watch means everything to me.
Listen, I'm expecting some people, so just have a look around. I'm going to start cleaning up the living room before they get here.
Oh, I can't believe this. There's that guy over there, my best mate, and the bridesmaid comes home and tells me she doesn't know why the wedding's off.
Why did Lorraine change her mind, Julie?
Last night, after her parents both got to bed, we started talking. About men and love and all those sort of things.
Go on.
Well, then about midnight, she woke me up to tell me she wasn't really sure if she loved Des. Oh, I mean, I told her not to be so stupid. She wouldn't be getting married today if she didn't love him.
Oh, and then what did you say?
Oh, now look, don't you go blaming me for this, Paul. All I said was with me, right? With me, it'd be love or nothing. Like it was with Mum and Dad.
And then what happened?
Then about 2 o'clock, she woke me up to tell me I was right. She was marrying Des for all the wrong reasons. And ever since, I haven't had a wink of sleep.
She's done it again.
Done what? What have I done?
You're always telling other people how to run their lives.
I am not. She asked me for my opinion, I gave it.
Is that all you said?
No, I mean, once she had decided the wedding was cancelled, the obvious thing to do is to reason with her, isn't it?
Oh, and give your opinion.
Oh, will you tell me, Paul, how do you reason with somebody without giving your opinion?
I'll tell you how you reason with somebody...
Everything I sincerely believe to be right, and there's Des to consider, remember that.
Yes, there is poor old Des to consider. Morning.
Hello, Des.
Oh, no! What have you done to our home? My furniture. Oh,
it'll be all right, Lorraine.
Perhaps this will help you realise you made the right decision this morning.
What's going on here?
Des. No, Lorraine, you agreed I'd do the talking. Lorraine isn't going to marry you. I can't say I'm sorry. In fact, I'm delighted. For all our sakes.
Well, just hold on a minute.
Please, let me finish. This family's always been prepared to face up to things. That's why the three of us are here this morning.
Hey, look where I found it. Mr. Kingham.
Daphne. What are you doing here?
Who is she? What was she doing in our bedroom?
Our bedroom? You're not going to marry me, but it's still our bedroom, is that right?
Who is she, Daddy?
Daphne worked for the firm for a short while. Receptionist, wasn't it, Daphne?
Yes. That was before the Sexual Harassment Act.
That still doesn't explain why she's here this morning at 8 o'clock.
You don't have to explain anything, Daphne. Unless you want to.
Sure. I was the stripper at the Bucks party last night.
Oh, great. Just great. Well, that's it then. We were going to discuss the furniture and things, but that can wait. All I want to do is get out of here.
I agree. Daphne.
So you're Daphne?
Mrs. Kingham, it wasn't like that.
Don't worry. I'm sure you had nothing to do with it. I know exactly what he's like. Des, Lorraine doesn't know how lucky she was.
They're leaving. What do you think? Do you think I should go in and see Des?
Julie, I think you should keep as far away from his place as possible.
No, but if the wedding's been cancelled, the guests will have to...
Just leave it, all right? Paul will let the guests know.
I just feel so terrible about it.
Maybe you should.
I guess I'll be going.
Yeah.
I'm sorry about your wedding.
It's unbelievable. She asked me to marry her, you know that. Now the blue, she just calls it off.
Would you like a coffee?
Yeah.
Tell you what, why don't you go and have a shower and get dressed?
Yeah, I will.
You there, mate?
He's having a shower. Hi.
You're from last night.
Daphne.
I didn't recognise you with your clothes on.
No one's ever cracked that joke before.
You didn't stay here last night, did you?
No. I'll make him a coffee. You want one?
Oh, no, thanks. Listen, I'm really sorry about all of this, mate.
Yeah, keep on thinking I must be dreaming. This sort of thing only happens to other people.
Yeah. Is there anything I can do?
Oh, I don't know. I mean, what do you do when something like this happens?
Listen, leave it to me. I'll phone some people, let them know. What about your mother in Perth?
What about her?
Well, will I call her?
You do that, it'll be the last call you ever make.
You want coffee in here?
Yeah, yeah. Listen, Des, you go and have your shower and I'll ring some people, all right?
Yeah, right, mate.
So I've changed my mind about the coffee. I will have some.
Black?
Yeah.
Have his. I'll make him another one.
Oh, thanks.
How is he?
Not good. Des, have you got Fred's number?
It's in the book.
Yeah, where's the book?
How the hell will I know?
This it?
Don't know. What's in it?
All girls.
It's not Des's. So I'll call Gary. Have a look around under there. It's bound to be under that mess somewhere.
Thanks.
Oh, Gary.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's Paul.
Paul who?
Oh, Paul Robinson, you turkey. Listen, the wedding's off, mate.
What time is it?
It's 9 o'clock. Did you get that? The wedding is cancelled.
Cancelled? You're kidding. What happened?
No, she stood him up.
Oh, my head. Oh.
What's the matter?
Oh, he's pretty upset about the whole thing. Listen, Gary, you call Steve and Bruce. I've got some calls to make. Gary? Gary? Gary, wake up, you dr... Oh.
This looks like the book. I'll go make his coffee.
Okay. Someone turned off the hot water.
I phoned everyone, okay?
Yeah.
Last one was Charlie. He asked if he could have his toaster back. Oh, come on, Des, cheer up, mate. Charlie's right. She just wasn't good enough for you.
I'm through with women, mate, I'll tell you that.
Oh, rubbish. You know, women fall over themselves to get to you. Lorraine just wasn't the right one, that's all. Well, you said yourself she was a ratbag when you first met her.
Yeah, well, it takes one to know one.
Listen, mate, the word is that she only got engaged to you in the first place to spite her old man.
Spite her old man?
Well, he didn't like you.
The only time you ever smiled at me was this morning.
You should have heard Glenn when I told him it was off. He died laughing and then said, now tell me the bad news.
Can you imagine him and the other guys when I get back from my honeymoon?
The honeymoon?
Yeah. Hey, the flaming honeymoon. What about the tickets? We're booked in the Hayman Island.
Oh, no. Can you get your money back?
Oh, how would I know?
Oh, better ring the travel agent.
Thanks, mate. The tickets are on the mantel.
How's Julie?
She's okay. She has right on her side.
I hope so.
Hello, Jim Helen.
Good morning. How's Max? He recovered from last night?
You know, Max. Blows hot and cold. I saw Lorraine and her parents. What happened to the wedding?
The bride decided she wasn't in love.
Poor Jess.
Yes, you have a lot to think about. The house and the mortgage.
Oh, those months he spent getting the place ready. Mind you, at one stage we thought he'll be marrying Julie.
Oh, no. I think they were just good friends.
I'll send Shane over when he gets back from training.
He'll need his friends around him. Must be a terrible blow to his pride.
$800. On top of everything else, I lose $800.
Yeah, well, the travel agent's right. I mean, it's all in this letter that they sent me.
I didn't even read a letter. I tell you, Paul, this really finishes me. I'm stuck with this house, all that furniture she insisted on. Now I've got a honeymoon I don't even want.
$800. I don't suppose you consider going on your own. Oh, you are still on holidays.
Hey, listen, I just heard about the wedding. It's terrible.
Yeah, thanks, Shane.
Well, isn't there something we can do about Lorraine, I mean?
Yeah, you can forget her. Listen, mate, I'll be back in a few minutes. Daphne wants to come.
Daphne? Last night's Daphne?
Yeah, yeah, she left a watch behind. Came back for it this morning. Hey, she's fantastic, you know. She's cleaned up his whole place in there.
So that's where she got to. Be back.
A date? A date?
We met last night at the party. You were supposed to come and watch me train this morning, remember?
Oh, you're,
Shane Ramsey.
Oh, of course, I remember. I didn't think you were serious.
Why wouldn't I be serious?
Oh, come on, you know a guy's life at a buck's knife. They all want to get off with a stripper. Occupational hazard. But anyway, you don't think I'd fall for that Olympic champion bull, do you?
I didn't say I was an Olympic champion, just that I was hoping to become one. Why are you doing all this?
It's a mess.
I was supposed to help clean it up.
Start in the bedroom.
Okay. Would you come and watch me train sometime? So as I can show off?
Are you serious about becoming an Olympic hope?
Well, my father is, and that's enough for both of us.
Okay. Maybe I will come and watch you show off.
Hey, why aren't you at the wedding?
The wedding was cancelled.
Cancelled?
She can explain all that to you later. Where have you been since the crack of dawn?
Oh, just out.
Okay.
Sure.
I see. You come in here after 2 o'clock this morning, then head off out a couple of hours later and you're okay.
Please, Dad, drop it, eh?
Scott. Can I have a word with you? Am I the enemy all of a sudden?
No.
Well, so what is it you can't tell me about?
Please, Dad.
Okay, we'll drop it. You know, I can't think of any trouble you could be in that I wouldn't try to help you out of.
Thanks.
What's her name?
It's just a girl from school. I've thought it out. It'll be cool.
You know, before your mother died, she asked me to take care of you 4 kids. I don't think she needed to worry about you, mate.
What are you doing?
Vacuum.
Oh, good boy. Good boy, that's what I like to see. More young boys should be helping their mothers with the housework.
Yeah. Well, I don't like to advertise it, but
Well, poor old mum needs a helping hand. And I'd like to do as much for her as I can. Gardening, ironing, mowing, gathering.
Don't let him fool you. He knocked a bowl of sugar all over the carpet. Well, next time you can do the whole house.
Mm. Listen, Grandma told me you had some more jam jars.
Oh, yeah? They're ready in the kitchen over there? Yeah.
A big scandal in the street, eh?
Well, if you're talking about the cancelled wedding, Danny, I'd have to say it was the best thing that happened to both of them.
Why? Des told me he was crazy about it.
Yeah. Des may have been infatuated, yes. But don't forget I was bridesmaid and therefore privy to exactly how she felt about him.
You thought they were madly in love. And...
Oh, yes, well, it may have looked like that.
You had the hots for Des once yourself, didn't you?
I did not have the hots for anyone, Danny. I simply went out with Des for a while as a friend.
I heard Lorraine took him off you.
Danny, would you do me a favour?
Shut up.
Don't worry about him. I used to know him when he used to wet his nappies, remember?
Very funny.
Anyway, let it be a lesson to you. When and if you ever get a steady girlfriend, it is far better to be honest if the relationship isn't working than to get married and regret it. Thanks for the jam jar, Mr. Ramsey.
All right.
You know the problem with some people? They walk away from a lousy marriage and then they go back to it.
Not anyone who did that.
You walked out on the old man once, didn't you?
Told you that.
Shane did. He remembers it when he was 4.
Well, Shane is wrong. I just simply went for holiday because your father couldn't go with me.
Well, Shane says that...
Look, I don't care what Shane says. Now drop it, Danny.
Where do you want the lamp to go?
Just over there.
Okay.
Great. Thanks for helping, Shane.
Helping? I've hardly done a thing. I reckon it looks brilliant.
So do I. I'd love to live in a place like this. Lorraine must have rocks in her head to turn a guy like Des down.
Yeah, he's a nice guy. I think Lorraine has got a few rocks in her head.
Her father nearly freaked out when he saw me here this morning. I worked for his firm for a while.
Get out. Honest. He's something else, isn't he?
He certainly is. Last in a long line of gropers. I didn't even say goodbye that time. I just walked out. And for the next 3 months, I kept on walking from one office to another.
Is that why you became a stripper?
Oh, it pays good money and I'm not ashamed of my body. I also never get involved with the customers.
Oh.
What?
I'm the customer, remember? I booked you.
Yeah. Well, I guess that's that then.
You can send the furniture back.
If they'll take it back. See what the guys have done to the bed?
Yeah.
Anyway, most of it's Lorraine's.
Oh. I didn't realise that.
Yeah, she wanted the expensive stuff.
Somebody spilled red wine all over the carpet down there. Daphne did a brilliant job getting it out.
All that booze for nothing, eh? The missus tells me you got stood up. At least she didn't wait for you to get to the church, eh?
Yeah.
Hey, listen, Jim. Can I have a lend of that saw? You also want to start in the ceiling.
Yeah, sure, mate. You know where it is. Just give us a yell if you need a hand.
Oh, beauty. Tom. Hey, what's your trouble?
Just trying to work out a few of Des's financial problems. You know, mortgage, that sort of thing.
Well, what's the hassle? I mean, one less mouth to feed, you're better off, aren't you?
Oh, yeah, that's very clever, Max. Of course, the fact that Lorraine was going to keep on working to help pay for it all is neither here nor there, I suppose, is it?
Oh, I see. Let's have a look. Huh? So you're up for an extra $100 a week,
that's
eh?
That's about it.
Simple. It's a big house. Answer a few ads, get a couple of people to share. Two blokes, $50 a week each, you're laughing.
That's not a bad idea in the meantime, Des.
It's a ripper. Yeah. Of course, you need a bond and stuff like that, bud.
Excuse me, Des. I'm off now.
Oh, well, gee. Thanks for everything, Daphne.
Take care, eh?
Hey, you're the stripper, aren't you?
No, I'm Daphne Lawrence. Nice to have met you, Mr. Robinson.
Nice to have met you too, Daphne. Thanks for your help.
What help? What's she doing here?
She's been helping me.
Oh, didn't take you long, did it, eh?
Now, look, Mr. Ramsey.
Ramsey? He couldn't be your father, could he?
Well, yes, what's you got to do with her?
Well, everything, I guess. I booked her.
Oh, so now I find out. My own son booking strippers. Do you know what she said last night? Told me to drop dead.
And why didn't you?
Blimey, strippers.
Relax, Mr. Ramsey. There won't be any more bucks party.
Yeah, well, there better not be. Start letting girls like that into a street like ours and it gets a bad name.
You let him get to you, that's all.
He reminds me of someone.
Who?
My father.
Well, you shouldn't know how to handle him then.
No, he didn't really bother me.
I want to see you again.
Can I be honest with you?
Sure, yeah, it's the best policy.
I want to see you again too.
Comes Lorraine on the phone.
Oh, how is she?
Upset. If you ask me, I think she's having second thoughts about Des.
You mean second thoughts?
Hmm. Oh, look, she went on and on and on about it. How do I
care?
Did I? What?
You were saying.
She went on and on about him. Had I seen him? Did I know about the girl that spent the night there? Oh, honestly, Grandma, I think it's a bit much of Des to have a stripper spend the night before the wedding.
What wedding?
Oh, you know what I mean.
Julie, the girl left her watch. She arrived just before Lorraine this morning.
Oh, did she? Oh, poor Des. He seems to be blamed for everything, doesn't he? Do you think it would help if I go and see him?
Do you want him back?
No, I don't want him back.
Good.
No.
Then keep out of it. Oh, would you mind putting that plant back so I can finish sketching it?
How do I look? Will I pass?
Yeah, you look great.
Now, what's the matter with you? Is it something that I've done?
Why you?
It's just that I catch you glaring at me.
It's not that.
Then what is it? Is it those nightmares?
What do you dream about?
Oh, usually just the old man yelling at me.
Another late night.
Yeah, a record. Two in a row.
Where are you going?
I'm taking a pretty girl out to dinner.
Oh, yeah?
You met her this morning, Daphne.
Oh, now, hold on.
Dad, it's none of your business, okay? Night, Mum.
Ciao.
Danny.
What are you going to do about this? No way a son of mine's getting involved with a tart like that.
Dad, he said it was none of our business.
And you keep your trap shut. Always putting your spoke in. Listen, love, I don't want you to encourage him with that girl. She's the wrong type.
She's the wrong type. You'd swear he was Lord Muck the way he carries on at times. If she's the wrong type, who the hell's the right type?
Don't ask me, ask her father.
I wouldn't ask him for the time of day.
So, once I agreed to train in earnest, I got myself a job gardening.
I like gardening.
See, we've already got something in common.
Mr. Lincoln.
The rose?
It's my favourite.
Oh, well, I'll bring you some. I work Thursdays for a widow who's got the most fantastic rose garden you've ever seen.
You can't take her roses.
Of course I can. She spoils me rotten. Always makes me a cake for afternoon tea and tells me to take whatever I like from the garden.
Widows can be dangerous.
Well, this one is. Must be 70 if she's a dad. Okay, I've done all the talking. Now, how about yourself?
What about me?
Well, all I know about you is that your favourite rose is Mr. Lincoln and that you were brought up in New Zealand.
Yes, I left there about 5 years ago. How's Des?
Oh, he's getting himself sorted out. He won't show it, but he's really cut up over all that.
That's what you get for rushing into marriage.
And now he's up to his eyes in debt. Dad suggested to him letting out the spare room to a couple of guys to help out.
He's going to rent that house.
Only a room and a useful place, you know.
How much?
I don't know. About $50 each guy or something like that.
It is a nice place. If I paid him $100, I could have my own room.
You?
Why not? You don't like the idea?
Like it? I think it's fantastic. Do you always make decisions so quickly?
Usually.
You'd just be two doors down from our house.
That's if Des agrees to it.
Ah, of course he'll agree to it. Look, would you like me to have a word
with
him?
No, I'll do it. First thing in the morning. Here's to your father.
My father?
It was his idea, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah, but I don't think you were exactly what he had in mind.
Right. Well, that's it. I think I'll lock up and call it a night.
Just a minute.
What?
For months now, you've been standing up and yawning at the same time and saying you'll lock up and call it a night.
So?
Jim, you're in a rut. The kids are out enjoying themselves. Why don't you get away from this house once in a while?
And why don't you practice what you preach?
You're in a rut, Jim Robinson.
I like it that way.
Dad.
What?
I got you another coffee.
Oh, thanks.
Better. Still got to watch that entry, bud.
Yeah, I know.
Here
you
go.
Hi. Dad, you remember Daphne, don't you?
What's she doing here?
I invited her. What'd you think?
Very impressive.
Yep. Well, we're going to stand here all day. We're going to get on with it, eh?
Sure. Mm. Well, look, I told Daphne about your suggestion.
What?
About renting a room with Des Clark.
Well, has he found someone yet?
I hope so.
Come on, let's go back in.
In a minute.
What's wrong with you?
Nothing. Do you ever see things?
What sort of things?
Accidents and things.
Yeah, I've seen accidents. What are you on about?
In dreams.
Dreams?
Ah, forget it.
Hey, come Sharon and the girls.
Hi.
Hi.
Where have you been?
Oh, the bus was late.
Where's Jill?
Couldn't make it. Oh, look what the cat dragged in.
Don't you ever let up.
Ooh, it's like that, is it?
She can't help what her mother's like. Hi, Kim.
Well, come on, let's get your gear on.
That's it, try that. That's better.
Is he really going to win a gold medal?
He sticks to his training, doesn't get mixed up with the wrong crowd.
Oh, is he mixed up with the wrong crowd?
Not yet. Not if I can help it.
How's it going?
I've enjoyed it.
Good, good.
Well, I'll be on my way.
Why?
Well, I've seen you train. That's what I came for.
Well, look, I'll be through in about half an hour. We can have a coffee.
Oh, no, I want to see Des. I don't want to miss out on that room.
What room?
Daphne's hoping to rent the room at Desi's place.
Now, look, Des is renting only to men, and they need crash-hot references.
No worry, Mr. Ramsay. I'll talk him around.
Well, you won't talk me round, but...
Oh, I see. You own the house.
Of course I don't own the house.
Then what's it got to do with you?
I'll tell you what it's got to do with me. There's no way I'm having a stripper living in my street.
Oh, it's the street you own.
Now, look, I'll have you know that that street was named after my grandfather, young woman.
Come on, Dad, look, this is between Des and Daphne.
Thanks for your help, Mr. Ramsay. Guess I'll be seeing you around. Bye, Shane.
Isn't he great? That's Danny's brother, Shane. I reckon he'll make the next Olympic team and win a gold.
I think Danny wants it.
Come on! In a minute! Oh, Danny's a good diver too. Almost as good as Shane. You sure you won't come in?
Can't swim. I booked a lesson, but the instructor didn't show.
Well, why didn't you say? Come on, I'll teach you.
Oh, no, thanks. I'm catching the next bus. Thanks all the same.
Okay. Maybe next time.
All right.
Good.
You're not concentrating. I mean, you say you understand what I'm telling you, but as soon as you get to the board, you forget.
Okay, so I forget.
Shane, this is Sharon. Hi, Sharon.
We've been watching you train. I think you're fantastic.
Thanks.
Will you really be going to the next Olympics?
Well,
now, look, how dumb can you get? You know how he needs his train. You start bringing kids up for a talk.
I was introducing a friend to my brother, all right?
Get in the pool or get off home.
Will you ever do that to him again, Dad?
Excuse me, Mr. Robinson.
Oh, good morning, Daphne.
I don't suppose you know where Des is.
Matter of fact, I do. He went down to the tip with Paul. She'll be back any moment, eh?
Good.
You did a nice job tidying up after that Bucks party.
Thanks. Mr. Robinson, I have to find a new place and I can afford the $100 Des needs.
Oh, it's great. Should sort a few problems out too, and it's a nice house.
It wouldn't worry you? Des sharing with a girl?
Why should it worry me? It's got nothing to do with me or anybody else. Of course, it's up to Des, but I hope you get it.
Thanks.
Sorry, it just wouldn't work.
Oh, come on, of course it'd work. Besides, you've seen what a great housekeeper Daphne is. Look, if you had two guys here, you'd just be falling over each other.
Listen, after what I went through yesterday, there is no way I'm going to rent to a woman. No offence, Daphne, but that's the way I feel.
Would you excuse us a moment, please, Paul?
Yeah, sure. Remember, she's offering you $100 a week, mate.
Des, I'm not trying to seduce you. Just rent a room.
Oh, don't worry, there won't be any seducing either side.
Good. Look, Des, you and I could do each other a favour out of this. I have to move out of the place I'm in, and you need a tenant.
With references and a bond?
No worries. I'd keep out of your way. It'd be strictly landlord and tenant.
Yeah. Yeah, you say that now. But after a while, you'd start... You know? Sorry, Daphne, I know what women are like.
You don't know what this one's like. Come on, Des, we could try it for a month. If it doesn't work out for either of us, I'll go with no hard feelings.
It isn't just that. Look, I've got nothing against you, okay? It's the neighbours. Oh, you've seen what Max Ramsey's like for starters. Can you imagine what he's going to say?
I'm not worried about what Max Ramsey will say, or the neighbours. I'd just like to hear what you say.
I mean, you should have seen her. Cool as a cucumber she was. Oh, it's the street you are. Cripes.
It's not really out of business, Max.
Our business if our son gets involved with a bus. What do you have to say when that happens?
Nothing. If Shane gets involved with any girl, it's his choice.
Well, I'll have something to say. Just you wait.
Max, she's just a girl. And all we know, she might be a very nice girl. Please don't be like that. Look, taste this and see if it's right for you.
Not enough salt.
You eat too much salt. Promise you won't keep on about that girl. You know what Shane's like.
Yeah, takes after his mother.
Yeah? Takes after his father.
It's only me.
Oh, come in, Jin.
I thought this might help get that ceiling down.
Oh, beauty, Jim.
Is it dried out yet?
Come and have a look.
Oh, that's looking better already, Max.
Yeah. In case I pull it down or it fall down, but...
Yeah.
Flaming kid. Flooded the whole house, you know.
Oh, well, accidents happen.
Accidents? Stupidity, more like. I mean, do your kids run a bath and then listen to rock music for an hour before they remember to turn the tap off, eh?
No, but I suppose it's always the first time. Let me know if you need a hand.
Thanks. Oh, Jim. Got a surprise for you. You know that stripper's trying to move in on Des Clark?
Yeah, I was talking to her earlier on. She seemed like a really nice girl.
Oh, what? Now, look, Jim, if a stripper moves into the street, property values would go down like a... And anyway, you know how some of the neighbours are about girls like that.
Well, I wouldn't worry too much about the warehouses. I think most of us are welcomer. See you later, Maria.
Bye.
Can you believe that? All the years I've known him, I never thought he'd welcome a woman like that into this street.
Jim Robinson is a very compassionate man.
Here we are, nice and cold.
Oh, lovely.
Here we are, Dad.
Hi, Mr. Robinson.
Hi, Daphne. How'd you get on?
I'm in.
Congratulations. Hi, Daphne, this is my mother-in-law, Mrs. Daniels, and my daughter, Julie.
Hello.
Hello, Daphne.
How do you do, Daphne? When do you move in?
Friday.
It's worked out well, hasn't it? See ya.
Who's this? I thought you'd know all about her. She's the notorious stripper.
Is that her? And what, she's moving in with Des?
Yes, she's moving in with Des. You see, your grandmother and I thought she'd be good company for him. Now that he's on his own.
Where does all the food go?
What?
When they cancel a wedding, where does all the food go?
Oh, Lucy, please, look, I've got more on my mind than leftover food.
She's pretty, isn't she?
Who?
Des's new girlfriend. I saw her talking to Dad.
Lucy, she's not Des's new girlfriend, all right? She's just a tenant.
I heard Uncle Max say she was going to give the street a bad name.
Hmm. Yeah, well, I agree with him. God, Des must have taken leave of his senses to let a girl like that move in.
If you would have married Des, you would have been living there, wouldn't you?
Yes, well, the point is, I didn't marry him, did I? If Des isn't careful who he lets his rooms to, he won't get a decent girl wanting to marry him.
What's the difference between a decent girl and a stripper?
Well, I'd like to think I'm a decent girl, and she isn't. That's the difference.
Oh.
So when Mum died, Grandma moved in. She's been there ever since.
Do you like her, your grandmother?
Yeah, she's great. She paints.
Oh, does she? Hey, look, I better go. I promised my mother I'd be home by 12.
Okay, I'll walk you home.
No, I'll be all right. You stay here and finish your ice cream.
Yeah, all right.
I'll see you at school. Bye.
Bye.
Oh, quick, shut the door.
Having trouble again, Mrs. Armitage?
Oh. One of these days, so help me, Paul, I'll part that mongrel's hair with an axe.
Now, Mrs. Armitage, what's that they say about turning the other cheek?
Turning the other cheek? You want to try living with that animal and turning the other cheek? You know what he'd do. He'd punch you right in the mouth, that's what he'd do.
Yeah, well, Grandma's in the garden. You want me to call her?
Oh, no, love. Just give me some sanctuary until he calms down a bit. Oh, I tell you this much. If my mother was alive today, she'd turn in her grave to see the way I'm treated. You should have seen him when I first met him. Butter wouldn't melt in his mouth. My parents forced this marriage on me, you know. They thought the sun shone out of his... Well, you know.
Look, Mrs. Armitage, have you ever thought of counselling?
You think I'm a bit off me head? Well, with all the knocking about I've had, I wouldn't wonder now. I wouldn't... Oh, well, hello, Mrs. Daniels.
Oh, there you are, Mrs. Armitage. I thought I saw you run in.
Oh, I'm sorry to do this to you again, Mrs. Daniels, but you know he always calms down after a bit.
Yes. Well, you sit there and chat to Paul, and I'll go and make a cuppa, and you can have it before you go.
Oh, look, I've always been a good woman, Paul. I mean, I do my best. I put ice in his beer, and he still hits me.
Hi, Mum.
Just in time. Get yours in the basket. You haven't seen Danny in your travels, have you?
Oh, I wouldn't worry about him. I don't think he's hungry.
That's not what your mother asked you. Do you know where he went when he left the pool?
He's at desk clerk's.
Oh, great. He's visiting the stripper. Ain't got the manners to tell his own mum he'd be late for a meal, but...
You embarrassed him this morning, Dad.
That'll be the day anyone embarrasses that smart aleck. Anyway, only told him what he already knows. Not to interrupt you when you're training.
It didn't worry me.
Well, it worried me. Look, if you want me to train you, you do things my way.
I'll go and ask Danny to come in for his meal.
Don't ask him, tell him!
It's always the same, you know. Well, he picks on me even when it isn't my fault. It's really great when a chick from your own class tells you to teach your old man some manners.
Oh, you can't really blame him. I mean, if Shane wants a gold medal, he'll have one hell of a time from now on.
I'll tell you something. It's the old man that wants that medal more than Shane. All my life, all I've ever heard him do is yap about winning.
Yeah, he used to be a bit of a sportsman, wasn't he?
Runner. Didn't make it. Well, that's why Shane's got to do it for him.
You want more coffee?
No, thanks.
Hi, your lunch is ready. How'd you go with Daphne?
We're giving it a trial. Strictly landlord and tenant, or out she goes.
Great. How about that, eh? All that sex and you get paid for it as well. Have you finished?
Yeah, take him home. He's getting insulting.
I'm going into town for a while.
Come on, Danny, look. You know what Dad's like. He's always saying things that he doesn't mean. Anyway, Mum's got your lunch ready.
He's always putting me down, Shane.
I know, but I'll protect you. Now, thank Des for the coffee.
Thanks for the coffee, Des.
That's all right. I'll see you both later.
He says one more word. Just one more word.
Now, don't get violent, Squirt. You know what you're like when you get violent.
Oh, I don't know if I really want to go away on this holiday Saturday.
Now, don't start that again. You know you're going to enjoy it once you get away.
Yes. You know how Lorraine phoned?
No. How's Lorraine, no?
Oh, well, I just couldn't tell about Des and that girl.
I shouldn't think so. Nothing to do with you or her.
Oh, well, I meant she was going to marry him, Grandma.
And stood him up at the last minute. What Des does now is his own concern.
Hi. Sorry, I'm a bit late.
Have a good swim?
Yeah, great.
Okay, round him up. It's ready.
I'll get it. Hello.
Hi, may I please speak to Scott?
Speaking?
It's Kim.
Oh, hi. I was just thinking about you.
I just wanted to thank you for this morning.
Oh, no worries.
I really enjoyed it.
Me too. I was going to ask you...
Well, Paul, call your father and Lucy,
sure, we could go out on Saturday.
Great.
Dad, Lucy, dinner.
We could have a meal, okay?
Sure.
Scott, Grandma's getting annoyed.
I'm doing no such thing.
I'll lend you time and place at school, okay?
Yeah, okay.
I've got to go. Bye.
Bye.
Who was that?
Oh, just Betty. She wants me to go out on Saturday.
Out? Where?
We haven't decided. Maybe the movies?
You know I don't like that girl.
Well, you don't like any of my friends. Anyway, I said I'm going and I'm going.
Hello.
Hi, Grandma.
How was school?
Okay.
Hi, Mrs. Daniels. Scott.
Hello, Lorraine. What are you doing here?
I've come to see Des. Is he home?
Yes, I think so. Are you sure you should be seeing him?
Oh, I'm not scared of him, if that's what you mean. After all, I was going to marry him. Oh, tell Julie I'll pop in and see her later on.
Has Daphne moved in?
No, not yet. But today's the day.
Yeah, but it wasn't my fault. My best man phoned as soon as I knew I wasn't going to get married. Doors open. Yeah, but $800. Come on, surely you must have sold those tickets to someone else when we didn't show.
Hello, Des.
Yeah. Yep. Listen, can I call you back? Yeah, before 5. Thanks. What are you doing here?
Visiting.
Visiting? Why?
I thought, if I could explain why I couldn't go through with the wedding.
You don't have to do that. As far as I'm concerned, it's all over and done with.
No, you don't mean that, Des. I know you too well. Because I know you so well, I kept thinking about you alone here without me all this week. Can't be easy for you going to bed at night knowing you should have been on your honeymoon.
Hey, what is this?
Okay. Maybe I made a mistake. But I thought we could be just friends. After all, we had a lot of fun together. And the more I think about it, the more I'm convinced I shouldn't have listened to my father and other people. Since I called the wedding off, everything's gone wrong. Mum's really upset. Dad's being just
Lorraine,
awful.
Lorraine, just don't do this to me, please.
And I left you with this lovely house. I know I've been unfair to you. Please let me try to make it up. I really miss you, Des. Hi.
Daphne. You remember Lorraine?
Hi, Lorraine. I'll go on through.
Through where?
I live here.
Just what does that mean?
It means Daphne lives here, as in sharing.
Oh, I see. She spends the night before our wedding with you, and now she's living here.
Now, hold on, Lorraine. This is really no concern of yours. You dumped me, remember? Daphne is simply a tenant.
A tenant?
Yes. You left me with a lot of debts, including a hefty mortgage on this house. I've got to pay out every week or I go under.
I'm dying for a cup of tea. Will you two join me?
Yeah, sure. Lorraine?
Sure. Why not?
I can't make out your year of birth.
It's 1970.
So, that makes you 15.
Yeah.
Well, Kim, what seems to be the trouble?
There's no trouble.
No?
Look, I just want to go on the pill, that's all.
Where have you been all afternoon?
I thought you had a meeting after school.
It was cancelled. Where were you?
I was listening to records.
Who with?
Mum, I wasn't doing anything wrong. I only listened to discs.
We had an agreement that you'd always tell your father and me where you were. That's all I'm asking.
I was over at Betty's.
Betty Regan?
Yeah.
And that's where you've been since you left school?
Yeah.
I phoned Betty over an hour ago. She didn't know where you were.
All right. I went to Oakley on the bus. That's the truth.
Oakley? Why?
Oh, Mummy said all you wanted to know was where I went. I went for a ride on a bus to Oakley. No one went with me.
Did you meet a boy in Oakley?
No, I didn't meet a boy.
Kim. Please don't lie to me.
If I lie to you, it's to stop you interrogating me like this. Oh, can't you understand? I'm not a child anymore.
You're 15.
Well, that's what I mean.
I was not. I was almost 17.
Were you pregnant?
Pregnant? What put that on?
Well, 16 was pretty young in those days, wasn't it?
There were extenuating circumstances, but pregnancy was not one of them.
Well, so you and Grandpa never, you know, before you got married.
Why all these questions about my sex life all of a sudden?
Oh, no reason. It's pretty quiet next door, isn't it?
Like the calm before the storm.
I'd give my eye teeth to know what's going on in there.
How long have you two known each other?
Only since my Bucks party.
Are you trying to make a fool of me or something, moving a stripper into our house?
Now, hold on, Lorraine. This is not your house. It's my house. And what Daphne does for a living has got nothing to do with you or me, okay?
No, it's not okay. It's not okay for you and it's not okay for me. It's stupid and childish. Daphne, for his sake, I think you should move out.
Sure. I told Des I'd go any time he changed his mind. If that's what you want, Des.
No, it's not what I want. You're staying and that's it.
Sorry. Looks like I stay.
Looks like you do. But I'd appreciate it if you'd refrain from using the kitchen and the furniture.
What do you mean?
This may be your house, Des, but I paid for most of the stuff in it. Of course, I'll give you the first option on it. Well, it's been an interesting afternoon. I'll see myself out. Goodbye.
I'm sorry, Des.
Can you believe that?
You sure you don't want me to move out?
Positive. Boy, did she do me a favour when she dumped me like that.
Hello there.
Hello, love.
What's going on next door? Lorraine just ran out in tears.
Oh? Did she say anything?
No? Oh, except that she wants Julie to ring her before she goes on holiday.
Oh, damn. Now I'll have to wait to find out.
We do love our little bit of gossip, don't we?
You've got to have a hobby.
Hi, Dad.
G'day, mate.
Oh, by the way, Grandma, I won't be in tomorrow night.
All right, dear. Going somewhere nice?
Oh, I'm just taking a chick out to dinner, that's all.
Never taken a chick out to dinner before.
Now, that new accountant, Jacobson, tells me his daughter's in your class at school.
Oh. Yes, Heather. I didn't connect them. She's not very bright.
That's funny. He seems to think she's very intelligent.
Well, I'm teaching her, and I can tell you he's wrong.
Maybe that she's just shy.
Shy? What's being shy got to do with it?
Darling, occasionally you can be a little overwhelming. Perhaps you frightened the kid.
Rubbish.
Dad's right, Mum. You've put a lot of kids offside since we came here.
I told you before what I think of that lot.
Kim's right, and you are putting them offside.
Kim is not right. But I don't think either of you are in any position to tell me how to conduct myself in a classroom.
I'm going to the pictures tomorrow afternoon, Dad.
Huh? I decided you shouldn't go.
Dad?
Your father agrees with me. That's it, Kim.
Hi, Mr. Robinson.
Why, Daphne? Settling in all right? Yeah.
Yeah. Hi. Just in time for breakfast.
Is this for me?
Sure. You can have scrambled eggs or a mixed grill.
A mixed grill? Are you kidding?
I forgot to warn you. I love cooking.
What a coincidence.
I love eating.
Well, why don't you start on the cereal?
Yeah, well, what about you?
I ate an hour ago.
Oh, g'day, Jim.
How's it going, Max?
Oh, getting on. Rhea tells me Julie's gone away for a week.
Yeah, up the mountains.
Oh, yeah. Saw you talking to the stripper earlier.
You mean Daphne, yeah. She's a nice girl.
Yeah, sure. Time will tell, but...
How's your ceiling, Max?
I might take you up on that offer of help, Jim.
Well, just give us a yell when you're ready.
What are you doing in here? You going to a funeral?
No, I'm not.
The doctor?
No.
Hey, listen, I thought we were going around to Eddie's to edit tapes.
Listen, some other time, I've got to go.
Well, you look marvellous.
Hey, where's he going, Mrs. Daniels?
Oh, I'm afraid only he can tell you that, Danny.
All set, mate?
Yeah.
Oh, Danny, your mother's been calling you.
Oh, thanks. See you later, mate.
See ya.
I thought that since you're taking this young lady out for dinner, you might like an advance on that gardening job you've been doing for me, hmm?
Yeah, that'd be great.
Do I know her?
It's Kim Taylor. Her mother's a teacher at school.
Oh, teacher. Well, if you want to bring her around here any time, you know she'd be welcome.
You won't ring her or anything. Her mother, I mean.
Why not?
Well, Kim hasn't told her we're going out yet.
And what are you going to do about that?
It's up to Kim.
No, no, it's up to both of you.
I'm going for a walk.
Oh, if you wait a few minutes, I'll go with you.
No, thanks.
Kim, there are things about Betty Regan you don't know.
Oh, she's promiscuous, is she?
Yes, she is.
You don't know that.
I know things about most of the students in my class that would horrify you. All I'm trying to do is protect you.
Do I need your protection to go for a walk?
Hi.
Sorry I'm late.
That's okay.
Are you going somewhere else?
No, what?
Well, you're all dressed up.
Yeah, for dinner.
Dinner? Sorry, Scott, I can't stay out that long.
Well, that's what I meant when I asked you out.
Didn't realise.
No worries, just like an ice cream.
Sure.
Yeah, that's better. What would you like to do?
I don't mind. What would you like to do?
I asked you first.
What would you like to do?
What would you like to do?
I asked you first. Hi, Kim.
Hi, Scott.
Come on, let's get out of here.
Look at him. Does he ever stop working and enjoy himself?
Not often.
It's a pity he never made again.
Don't tell me, tell him.
Does this look all right?
Good afternoon, Mrs. Daniels, Mrs. Ramsey.
Hello, Lorraine. What are you doing here?
I've just called to collect a few bits and pieces. Hello, Mr. Robinson.
I don't think there's anyone home, Lorraine.
Oh, that's okay. I still have my key. I'll leave Des a note. Oh, did Julie get off all right?
Yes, thanks.
Good. See you later.
Boy, oh boy. Did I have a narrow escape?
I'm sorry, Des. When we saw all the furniture going, we thought you must have agreed to it.
Listen to this. Dear Des, I have listed the things I have taken. They all belong to me. At least you and your lady friend still have a bed. Lorraine.
What happened?
Lorraine happened.
Look, until you sort yourself out, we've got a few bits and pieces you can use at home. And as far as the kitchen goes, I think Helen's got enough to furnish three houses.
Thanks, Jim. I'm sorry, Daphne. This is hardly the deal we agreed.
What do you mean?
Well, you're paying for a furnished house,
Anna. Oh, hey, that's the least of our worries. When I was in Japan, we had a room just like this one. It was great.
You've been to Japan?
Yes, it's kind of you to help, Mr. Robinson.
Not at all. Let's go next door and have a look, see what we can find, huh?
Yeah. Okay. How much further?
It's just here.
I hope it's worth it.
It is.
Oh, wow. How'd you ever find this place?
It's an old monastery. I also shot a lot of films and commercials out here. Come on.
Are you sure it's all right?
Of course. Nobody comes near the place now.
Do you wonder what life was really like in those days? We went to a pioneer park once. Those houses were so tiny. You should have seen the beds. It wasn't that long ago, was it? Only about... Scott? Scott? Come on. Okay, smart aleck. I'll count to five and then I'm going home. One, two, three, four.
Come on, admit it. You were scared.
I was not scared.
Yes, you...
Help me!
Scott!
Save me!
Scott? Are you all right? Oh, no. Scott, can you hear me? Go and get help.
No. No, don't leave me.
Oh, you...
Who said she wasn't scared? You really thought they had me, didn't you?
You're very funny. The next time you want to put your hand around your own throat, do me a favour and choke yourself. I'm going home.
See you at school.
Drop dead.
Oh, come back to apologise, have you?
You've got all my money, remember?
So I have. How much was it again?
$10.
Sorry.
Thank you.
Can we kiss and make up?
Okay.
We could sit over there if you'd like.
I'm good now.
Come on, just for a little while.
No.
Okay. Okay, forget it.
Scott, don't be like that.
Like what?
That's what you brought me here for, isn't it? Sex.
Yeah, and I'm a school rapist.
I went to see a doctor to go on the pill.
Pill? Why?
Because this has never happened to me before, that's why.
Did he put you on the pill?
Talk me out of it. Sorry.
Hey, it doesn't matter.
Oh, good heavens, she didn't leave much, did she?
Only the carpets and the curtains, and I'm paying those off myself.
Still can't understand why Lorraine didn't offer to let you take the furniture over.
She said she would. And she changed her mind. Lorraine's famous for changing her mind.
I'm sorry we can't help you out with the bed, Des.
I feel really sorry for Daphne. You know, this place just felt so cosy, just right. And then wham, Lorraine struck. I'll never afford furniture like that again.
Well, well, well. Bit of a come down from all that posh furniture, isn't it, eh?
Oh, I don't know. It's perfect for parties at the moment.
Yeah. When I saw the big van roll up, I hoped you and the stripper might be moving out altogether.
Oh, no, no, no. We're going to rage on from time to time, Mr. Ramsay.
Yeah, don't doubt it. Oh, and a word with the young lady who called the wedding off. You know, I felt that sorry for her. I nearly helped her load the furniture.
Mm. Tell Daphne if she needs anything else to let me know, Jess.
Thanks. I don't know where she is at the moment.
Oh, she's working, is she?
Yeah, right, Max. Let's leave Des to it, shall we? He has to get himself a bed. Unless, of course, you've got a spare one you could lend him.
Nah, afraid not.
Well, it's the thought that counts, isn't it, Max?
Mm-hmm. Hi, Mum.
Hi. Hello, Eddie.
Boy.
Have you had a nice day?
Yeah, not bad. I might go over to Eddie's place and edit a few tapes.
Oh, no, you won't. You give me a hand with the ceiling as soon as Shane gets home.
Well, I promised Eddie.
It's okay. I'll do it by myself, Mr. Ramsay. No sweat.
Yeah. Well, there you are. Eddie's happy. I'm happy. You should be happy as well.
Thanks for nothing.
Oh, I can.
Home at last, I see.
Yep.
How's the film?
I didn't go. You and Mum said I couldn't, remember?
Oh, Mother was only trying to protect you, kid.
Oh, what about you, Dad? You never tell me what you want.
Well, I want what's best for you, of course. Besides, from what your mother says about the kids at school, I think her attitude is right where you're concerned.
What about when I meet a boy? What are you going to do about that?
Well, as long as he's the right one for you, that's all that matters. Anyway, we don't have to worry about that now. We'll wait until you grow up.
Oh, I am growing up, Dad.
Nonsense, you're still a baby.
Dad.
How long have you been back?
A little while.
I've been out looking for you.
Why, it's only 5:30.
Yes, it's 5:30. You went for a walk 3 hours ago.
Okay, I went for a walk 3 hours ago. So what?
So where have you been?
It's my business.
Did you go to the pictures after all?
No, I wouldn't dare, would I? Oh, look, Mum, you don't own me. If I want to go out, I'll go. The more you butt into my life, the more I'm just going to do things my way.
You see, I can't even ask her what she's been doing without getting abused.
Oh, perhaps if you got off her back for once. Well, I mean, she's probably lonely being cooped up with just us all the time. Perhaps if we invited her friends back to the home instead of
letting her
go out.
There is no way that I'm having that lot in this house. If you could see them in the classroom, you'd understand why. I'll make some tea.
Damn it!
Such language.
Daphne?
I've got a surprise for you. Close your eyes.
I've had enough surprises to last me a lifetime.
Oh, now don't be a spoil sport. Close them.
Okay, you satisfied?
Ta-da! Have you eaten?
No. What happened here?
I'll tell you over dinner.
I'd love to see Desi's face when he sees that furniture. I wish I could have seen Max's face when that second van pulled up.
Don't, Helen. You know how Max feels about this street. The poor girl hasn't done him a bit of harm, and he just goes on about having a stripper in Ramsey Street.
He told me his grandfather would turn in his grave.
Hi, Grant. Oh. Mrs. Ramsey.
Hello, dear. Have a nice day.
Hi, Paul.
Yeah, great.
If you're hungry, go to the fridge.
Where is everyone?
Your father is next door helping Mr. Ramsey. Your little sister Lucy is upstairs asleep. Your older sister Julie has gone away for the week. And your brother Scott is out for dinner.
I had to ask dinner. Mm.
And you also missed the excitement in the Clark household.
What do you mean, Des?
Lorraine arrived this morning and took all the furniture.
What?
Just left them with the carpets, the curtains, and Daphne's bed.
Oh, what a lousy trick. I tell you, that guy doesn't realize how lucky he was when she dumped him. Let me see if there's anything I can.
Yeah. Take a pot of jam.
I'm sure this will really cheer him up.
I know I should have told him about the new furniture, but he's always playing practical jokes on me.
I told you I'm not hungry.
I just don't believe this. I go to all this trouble to refurnish the house, and what do I get? Abuse.
I did not abuse you, Daphne. It's just that I can't accept that furniture, that's it.
I'm not asking you to accept it. It's under my name, and it'll be my responsibility. And if I decide to move out, which could well be this evening, I'll take the damn lot with me.
Oh, great. Great. Can you imagine the neighbours if another van load is shifted?
So, now you're worried about the neighbours.
I'm not worried about the neighbours.
Yo, anyone home?
No.
Sorry I wasn't here this afternoon. Grandma told me about Lorraine. They told me all your furniture is. Is this a joke or something?
You tell me.
And what are you sulking like that for?
I'm not sulking.
Yes, you are. Lorraine took all the furniture when we were both out. I managed to replace everything, and Des doesn't like it.
You don't like it? It looks fantastic. In fact, it looks better than it did before. You're mad, you know that.
Have you finished?
Oh, no. Grandma gave me this jar of jam. And if you're not eating that chicken, I wouldn't.
I'm going for a walk.
Okay, see ya.
I honestly thought he'd be over the moon when he saw all this stuff.
Oh, he'll be okay.
How can you say that? I've been here less than 2 days and we've had a row already.
Ah, Des enjoys a good row. He's also very independent. Look, when he realised he couldn't afford to get married unless Lorraine chipped in, it hurt him. No, true, it really hurt him.
And then she dumped him on the day of the wedding and capped it all off by taking his furniture back. He's just a bit sensitive about trusting another woman, that's all.
I was only trying to make things better for him.
Oh, you are. He just hasn't realised it yet.
I never eat this jam, you know.
Oh, that's great. I'm making Maria's jam for the fete, and she hasn't even tasted her own recipe.
That's my mother's recipe. I never knew it so well out over here.
Poor Danny. At least he gives as good as he gets.
I wish you could complain occasionally. At least they would turn it down.
Oh, no, it's your family. You do your own dirty work.
Oh, some friend you turn out to be. You really are my best friend.
What brought that on?
probably jam. Remember, when you first met me, you gave me a pot of jam?
Well, I wish I could remember things like that.
And I also remember how you saved my marriage.
Rubbish. How are things between you and Max?
Oh, all right. I think I should have told him the truth about Danny.
You know my feelings about that.
It's probably what's wrong between them. Max must be wondering. Oh. Perhaps I have to tell him the truth one day.
Who is it?
Only me.
Hi, Mrs. Ramsey.
Hi, Scott.
You're early. How was dinner?
We didn't go to dinner.
Where's Dad? Next door.
He's doing the ceiling with Max.
Nice jam.
Danny's at home. If you want to go in.
Yeah, thanks. I think I will. See you later.
Hang on, mate. I just did it in the middle here.
Where's that flaming kid gone?
It's okay, Max.
Danny! Get back in here!
I can manage, mate.
Well, you shouldn't have to manage. It's his job. Danny!
Make your mind up. You told me to put the bloody kettle on, remember?
It doesn't take all night to put a kettle on. Now get that broom and hold that end up.
Hi.
Hi. Good, mate.
Where have you been all night?
Well, you had a date with the teacher's daughter. You should have seen him at the ice cream parlor.
Look now what the buffhead's done! You can't even hold a broom against a bit of plaster, can you?
It wasn't his fault, Dad.
It wasn't his fault. Nothing's ever his fault. God help him if he ever tries to hold down a job.
Oh, I'll get a job. And when I do, I'm going to move out.
Oh, you're always promising. Listen, any time you want to go, you go. But you know where you're going to end up? In the gutter with all the other deadbeats. Well,
anything would be better than this dump.
You're being a bit hard on young Danny, Max.
Look, I don't tell you how to handle your kids, Jim.
Always me. When does he ever yell at Shane?
When does Shane ever yell at him?
Yeah. Hey, you want to hear the edit we did on the old man and Mum?
Yeah, sure.
Eddie taped Mum talking to the old man and then him yelling at me. And we swapped it all around. Have a listen to this.
They've asked if I'm
going to
make some jam for the fete.
You're a drunkard! You're no flaming good and you never will be.
You've got a sweet tooth. That's your trouble.
Don't you yell at me!
I think I'll tell him if we can make it next door.
You want to leave us? You leave home. It's bloody good riddance.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Yeah, wait till Mum hears it. And wait till you hear the one Eddie's working on right now.
Oh, darling. I know. Believe me, Mrs. Daniels, I won't even burden you with the way he's treating me. I thought, on the way over, I've inflicted too much of my husband's brutality on you and your family, and it's just got to stop.
Yes, you're right. Yes. It has got to stop.
Oh, Mrs. Armitage.
Oh, hello, Mrs. Ramsey.
I'll be up home, Helen.
Oh, no, please don't go. I want to talk to you both.
It is rather late, Mrs. Armitage.
Oh, it's almost too late for some of us. That mongrel. You should have heard what he threatened to do to me tonight. You've always been so good to me, both of you, when I needed someone, but I know it just can't go on like this.
Oh, it can't.
I've always resisted leaving him because of the house, you understand. But someone's got to move, and it's obvious which one it has to be.
Oh, have you got somewhere to go?
No, I'm not moving anywhere. He's the one who has to be thrown on the pavement, bags and all. So if your husbands and boys would come right back with me now, we'll soon put some peace and quiet back into Ramsey Street.
Ah, now, just a minute, Mrs. Armitage. Are you suggesting our men help you kick your husband out of his house? Oh, it's just not on.
Why not? You've known for years that he belts me up.
Well, there's no way our families are going to get involved with some vigilante nonsense.
I see. You're both prepared to climb into your beds with my possible death on your conscience.
Oh, you do know how to strain a friendship. Now, come up here. That's right. Now, if you really want to do something about your husband, pick up the phone and call the police.
The police? I don't want them messing about in my private affairs. Thank you for your help. I don't think I'll bother you again. Good night. Good night, Mrs. Ramsey.
Good night.
Good night.
Police. And to think your husband got his knickers in a knot because a quiet little stripper moved into the street. Oh.
Hi. You in bed?
No. Just waiting for you.
For me? Why would anybody want to wait for me?
Would you like tea or coffee, a drink?
No, thanks. I guess we're not the only ones who fight a bit. You heard the Ramses as I walked by.
Some of it filtered through to here. Des, I'm sorry I upset you. It's the last thing I'd want to do.
Oh, no, it's my fault. The place looks great, really great. I appreciate what you did. Just with Lorraine and all this carry-on, it's just made me a bit wary about accepting favours.
So, we don't send the furniture back?
No. No, not unless we both muck in to pay for it.
Suits me. See you tomorrow, then.
There's just one small thing. Did Paul eat all that chicken? I am starving. Hello.
How'd you like your surprise?
Oh, Lorraine, how could you do such a rotten thing?
I moved some of it into my bedroom.
Yeah, I see. You're wallowing in comfort while I haven't even got a cushion to sit on, is that it?
That's it. Of course, if you're interested in discussing the return of the furniture, we could always negotiate.
Lorraine, could you do me a favour?
What's that?
Don't hold your breath.
Hey, Grandma, how's that shirt going?
Ready.
Want one of the papers, Scott?
No, thanks.
You can go out today?
Oh, I might. I haven't made up my mind yet.
What about you, Paul? What are you doing?
Oh, I don't know yet. Anything in the papers?
Lots of advertisements. Lucy, you sure you won't change your mind and come to the zoo with us?
No, thanks. I think I'll just hang around here for a while.
Grandma's just packing the hamper.
Oh, great. Well, you can help me get the car out. If you do change your mind and go out, make sure you lock the door.
Sure, okay. Have a nice time.
I always have a great time at the zoo.
So do I.
Hello. Are you sure you won't come with us?
Yeah, I'm sure. Have a good time.
They hang up?
It's important they'll obviously ring back.
It's probably one of those young idiots from school. Wouldn't mind if what they do is funny, but it's sordid. Should have seen the magazine I confiscated on Friday. Headmaster's too tolerant for some of those kids.
Well, I'll make an issue of it. Tell him.
Oh, I've told him. Thinks I'm too tough. Old-fashioned. I'd like to see him control that class of mine. It's all right for him sitting at his big desk.
Yeah. By the way, have you made a decision about Margaret yet?
Yes, let's take her to lunch. Poor beggar hardly ever gets invited out.
Well, do you mind if I don't come today, Mum?
Well, you know how your Aunt Margaret loves to see you.
I just don't feel up to going out today.
What's the matter? Don't you feel well?
I'm all right. I just feel like a day by myself.
See you later, okay?
See you later.
Oh, you've got to stop spoiling me like this.
It's no trouble. Besides, I don't enjoy cooking just for myself.
Well, I'll tell you what, we'll make a deal. You do the cooking, I'll do the washing up.
Do you mean it?
Yeah. And just to show that I won't take advantage of you, we'll go to a restaurant every now and then.
I'd like that.
What are you going to do today?
You guys both decent?
What do you mean, decent?
Oh, I can see you're in a better mood today.
Would you like a cup of tea?
Yeah, sure, I'll get it.
Listen, Daff, I was wondering if you'd like to come to the beach today.
That sounds like a good idea.
Yeah, okay, I will. Thanks, Paul.
What are you doing today, mate?
Well, I thought...
Oh, he's got a lot of washing up to do. Well, I'll be ready by the time you finish your tea.
Great. I can see you apologise to him, mate.
Apologise for what?
Oh, come on, you were like an ungrateful kid last night.
Okay, so I was like an ungrateful kid. Are you satisfied? Hmm?
Yeah, I'm satisfied. Listen, you can come to the beach with us if you want, but I prefer you didn't.
Well, it's okay, I've got a lot
Anyone home?
Nah, go away.
Good morning. Hey, this looks really great. Even better than it was before. The old man said that Daphne turned up with it in a van. Is it all hers?
It's ours. Des and I have an agreement.
How are you?
I'm fine, thanks. How's the training going?
Great, great. Hey, why don't you come with me today?
Sorry, Shane. Paul's just asked me to go to the beach. Some other time, though. I'd really like that.
Sure, sure. Anytime.
Well, you guys, have a nice day and we'll see
you. Yeah, see you both later.
Bye, Des. You can call me in the fridge for your lunch.
Thanks. See you later.
I didn't hear you coming last night.
Ah, that's because I'm very considerate. You come in and wake up the whole household. Me, on the other hand, am very quiet, Stan.
What I'd call a quiet worker.
We had a great time at the zoo yesterday. Dad said he might get me a little dog for my next birthday.
Only if you look after it and take it for walks.
Right, I'm off. Scott, you'll have to take Lucy to school today.
Oh, Dad?
Oh, nothing. I'm running late already. You have a good time. I'll see you tonight. And don't fight with your brother.
But he doesn't want to take me to school.
Rise above it. See you, Mum.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye, Dad.
Are you ashamed of me? Is that it?
Yes.
In, are we?
Yeah. I'm really sorry about yesterday. I'd like to watch you train again.
Sure, why not?
Morning, Mr. Ramsey.
Morning.
Well, I'd better run. See you later. Hi. Have you had breakfast?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, Des. I was hoping to be home in time.
Oh, this is your home, is it?
Yeah.
And you didn't turn up last night. I thought you might have moved out or something.
No, I just didn't come home, that's all.
Did you spend the night with Paul Robinson, did you?
No, I did not.
Then where were you?
Oh, hold on a minute, Des. That's got nothing to do with you.
Oh, I see. So next time you go out and you don't come home, I don't worry. Is that right? I mean, some of those loonies you strip for might be carving you up in a back alley, but it's got nothing to do with me. I'll keep out of it.
Don't be like that.
Like what? Look, I know it's a bit square of me to expect you to phone whenever you're not coming home, but I'll know what to do in future. I'll know better next time.
If you must know, I didn't phone because I thought I might wake you up. Next time I will.
No, 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 forget it. You're right, it's got nothing to do with me. You live your life the way you want. I'm going out.
Hi.
Hi.
Sorry, I'm a bit late. I had to take my kid sister to school.
That's okay. What did you do yesterday?
Well, nothing much. I tried to ring you once.
About 9 o'clock?
Yeah.
We just got in from church. My mother answered it.
Yeah, I know. It scared the hell out of me. I was going to ask if we could get together.
I'd have liked that.
Next Saturday, still okay?
Yeah.
Come on, we better go. You know, your mother's like if anyone's late.
Hmm.
Mrs. Tull. Whatever's on the tape is obviously very funny. Can we share the joke?
No.
No? Let's hear it, Eddie.
It's just some crazy stuff, Mrs. Taylor. Just some stuff we did together over the weekend.
Sounds fascinating. Play it. Perhaps you realize just how unfunny your smutty humor is. Get ready to laugh, everyone.
I don't want to play the tape, Mrs. Taylor.
Do as you're told.
Oh, God, don't be like that.
I'm the school rapist.
This is what you brought me here for, isn't it? Sex.
Sure. How much was it again?
$10. Doctor, to go on the pill.
Stop it. Switch
it off. Neighbours. Everybody needs good neighbours.
And we're bang up to date with Neighbours nearly 2,000 episodes further on at 5:35 this afternoon. Or an hour later if you're in Northern Ireland.
Neighbours need to get to know each other. Next door is only a footstep away. Neighbours, everybody needs good neighbours with a little understanding. You can find the perfect blend. Neighbors should be there for one another. That's when good neighbors.